In 1873, in Newfoundland, Canada, three fishermen were out on a small fishing boat in Conception Bay when they spotted something strange in the water. A large mass seemingly floating on the surface. Curious, the men approached the object and attempted to pull it closer with a hook. It's then the men realized the creature was a large giant squid, and it was alive. The large creature grabbed the small fishing boat and tried to drag it under. The men, armed with hatchets, fought back and chopped off one of the tentacles and injured the creature enough that it let go, and the men went back to the shore. They brought the tentacle with them and sold it to a local reverend and naturalist named Moses Harvey. A few days later, that same reverend encountered other fishermen who had come into contact with another giant squid. This time, the fisherman had the entire body. Reverend Moses Harvey bought the big creature, and with the help of the fishermen, he brought it back to his house and placed it in a bathtub with its legs drooping out. He then took out his camera and took the first ever picture of a giant squid. Of course, the huge squid had been heard of before, perhaps dating all the way back to Aristotle in the 4th century BCE. He described a large squid called Toothus. He said it was much larger than the other squid, or as he called them, Toothis. In the 1st century ACE, Gaius Plinius Secundus, also known as Pliny the Elder, wrote Naturalis Historia, in which he described a huge squid with arms reaching 30 feet in length. There are also legend and stories we're all at least vaguely familiar with, like the Norse Kraken, as well as other different fishermen tales of sea monsters. There are all those classic illustrations of ships fending off huge squids as they try to wrap around the hull. It's sort of a classic image, and it comes up a lot. And those men being attacked in the bay. It sounds a bit out there, but there are many more accounts dating all the way up to modern times. And it makes me wonder, do giant squid attack ships? So what do we know about giant squid? Well, to be honest, not much. The first picture of a dead giant squid was taken in 1873, and it would take another 131 years to get a picture of a living one. This picture is from a series of pictures taken by Tsunemi Kubodera and Kyoichi Mori in 2004. They were taken 970 kilometers south of Tokyo. It took the team 2 years to get the footage of the squid. Not too surprising considering the estimated range of the squid is 300 to 1,000 meters deep. Though this squid lives in the depths of the ocean, it seems to have a wide range throughout the planet, occurring in all the world's oceans. It is speculated that there may be multiple different species of the giant squid. I've seen some lists suggesting there are 8 different species. Some lists even go up to 17. But in March of 2013, researchers at the University of Copenhagen discovered that based on DNA evidence, there is really only one species of giant squid. Sounds weird, but I guess the data doesn't lie. Again, we don't know a whole lot about this squid, but perhaps if we take a look at some of its more common relatives, we can determine if they could pose a possible threat to humans. When you start looking for aggressive squid and squid attacks, your search will eventually yield the Humboldt squid. They're not near giant squid size, but they are relatively big for a squid, growing to about 1.5 meters in length. They are known by a few different names, such as jumbo squid, jumbo flying squid, and in Mexico they have the name Diablos Roja, or Red Devils. One, because they can rapidly flash from white to red, and two, because they have a reputation for being aggressive. How aggressive, though, is a bit difficult to say for certain. They definitely have attacked some humans. Some stories are hard to verify, but a cameraman working for Animal Planet was attacked by Humboldt squids, and this was captured on camera. So we know they have attacked, but I don't know if they have killed. It seems that it could be possible, since they dragged the aforementioned cameraman deeper into the ocean. It seems feasible that they might kill someone by drowning them. To be fair, I should mention that it is contested just how aggressive these squids are. Other divers had said swimming with them is perfectly fine, as long as they aren't feeding or being hunted. And it is hunted quite a lot. Apparently it's the most hunted squid in the world. In 2019, a third of all squid caught were Humboldt. But let's go back to the bigger variety. What happens when the giant ones get aggressive? Let's look at reports of giant squid attacks. One of the earlier accounts comes from 1782, with a French ship known as the Ville de Paris, a large three-deck ship that was used during the American Revolutionary War. According to the story, the ship sailed with a company of 9 other ships before it was attacked by a huge giant squids and dragged to the bottom of the ocean. There is a record of the ship going down, and it went down off the coast of Newfoundland, where giant squids are often found. But it was also reported that the ship was taken out by a hurricane on the Atlantic. A hurricane seems more likely, honestly. The Ville de Paris was a large vessel, at about 54 meters long, and had 500 sailors on board. Would a squid, even a giant one, be able to drag a ship like this under? Well, let's look at how big giant squid actually are. A lot of the time when we find specimens, they aren't perfectly intact. Often, only a partial carcass washes up on the shore, as the dead squid was preyed upon by other animals. But using 130 specimens, as well as beaks found inside sperm whales, it is estimated that females can grow to a max length of about 12 to 13 meters, and males to about 10 meters. Let's not forget, though, about half of that length is made up of the squid's 2 feeding tentacles. And these giants are surprisingly light. Males' estimated max weight is about 150 kilos, and for females it's about 275 kilos. This isn't particularly heavy, so it doesn't seem all that possible to me. There are a couple of counterpoints, though. Some scientists do think that giant squid may actually be capable of growing up to 20 meters. And the story does mention squids, plural, so maybe multiple squids tried to drag the ship down together, like Humboldt squids. Even still, the hurricane explanation seems a lot more plausible reason for the ship's demise. Of course, we have the 1873 incident in Newfoundland, and then the following year, a similar incident in India. A few men were in a small sailboat in the Bay of Bengal and spotted a large creature floating on the surface. They took shots at the creature, which apparently made it mad, and it attempted to climb onto the boat, capsizing it in the process. Another ship, the Strathone, picked up the survivors, but apparently 2 sailors died in the arms of the squid, and another sailor may have drowned. For the next attacks, we have to travel forward to the 20th century. It was at the beginning of the 20th century that a new, even larger squid was discovered. This new squid was first discovered in 2 arm crowns found in the stomach of a sperm whale during the winter of 1924-25. This creature would later be called the colossal squid. While the estimated max length is less than a giant squid, estimated at about 9 to 10 meters, as opposed to the giant squid, which is estimated to get up to 12 to 13 meters, the colossal squid is much heavier, with the species confirmed to have reached a mass of at least 495 kilos, and partial remains from other colossal squid suggest they might even get up to 600 to 700 kilos. It also has a deeper range at about 500 to 2,000 meters, and it's not as spread out as the giant squid. It seems to mostly be found around the Antarctic and Southern Ocean. Since the colossal squid is found so far south, I think most of the attacks were likely dealing with the giant squid. But I guess we should keep it in mind, because maybe some of the accounts could be describing a colossal squid. Okay, so, Moving a few years forward to 1930, we get accounts of a Norwegian tanker named the Brunswick. While the Brunswick was traveling in the South Pacific between Hawaii and Samoa, the ship was attacked by a giant squid. The large squid tried to grab the ship with its tentacles, but the metal body of the ship was hard to stick to, and the slippery surface didn't help either. And the squid slid back into the propeller and died. As fantastical as this story sounds, it was confirmed by a commander of the Royal Norwegian Navy. Incredibly, he stated that the ship had been attacked by a giant squid three separate times between 1930 and 1933. What were these squids up to? Forget the Ville de Paris being large. The Brunswick was a 15,000 ton tanker. Why would a squid think they could take this out? Well, I have some theories, but let's look at some other reports first. Okay, not gonna lie, this next account is a bit out there. The story comes after the sinking of the Britannia in 1941. According to the account, some of the survivors were attacked by a giant squid while in the water. Some were even killed by the squid. This account also contains the description of a man who had his legs bitten off by a shark before being eaten by a giant manta. What? I mean, shark attacks are pretty rare, but they do occasionally happen. But being eaten by a giant manta? Giant manta have big mouths, but they are filter feeders and don't have the ability to swallow anything bigger than plankton. Even if a fish gets into their mouth, they spit it out. They don't even have any suction to their mouth and have to swim through their food. I don't know how someone could be eaten by this. Also, how unlucky that a shark, a manta ray, and a giant squid all decided to team up and attack at the same time. Unless it's supposed to be one of those cases where the commotion of the ship sinking and or blood in the water brought them together. Maybe. Hard to swallow this story, but surprisingly, some of it has been verified. One of the survivors of the encounter, Lieutenant Raymond Edmund Grimani Cox, had scars on his body. Cox's scars were examined at Birkbeck College, and it was determined that the marks were made by a squid that was probably 23 feet long. So I guess there is something to this story, but I still feel skeptical about some parts. Unfortunately, our next account also contains fatalities. According to the Hungarian news site Origo, in 1989 in the Philippines, a group of fishermen had to rescue a group of 12 survivors who were clinging to an overturned boat. What caused their boat to overturn? Well, according to the people who were rescued, the boat had been turned upside down by a giant octopus or giant squid. Interestingly though, they note that the creature did not attack them after. Unfortunately though, a 12-week-old boy did drown. Moving past the millennium now to 2003, we get a report from Olivier de Kersauson, a French sailor and sailing champion. He was competing for the Jules Verne Trophy, which is a prize for the fastest circumnavigation in a yacht. Sort of an ironic name considering the Nautilus was attacked by a giant squid in the Jules Verne novel 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. Anyway, about 7 hours after Olivier set sail from Brittany, France, the squid attacked. The squid latched onto the ship, blocking the rudder with its tentacles. Olivier stopped the boat and the squid swam off. Olivier said, "We didn't have anything to scare off this beast, so I don't know what we would have done if it hadn't let go." An even more recent encounter happened in 2017, when a giant squid grabbed the surfboard of a surfer. Fortunately, none of the people got hurt, and I don't want to say too much more because I don't really want to spoil someone else's video, so I'll leave a link below if you want to watch it later. Anyway, now that we have all these different pieces, let's try and put it all together. Let's figure out what was happening. Okay, firstly, like I said before, the squid live in deep ocean, 300 to 1,000 meters down. They prey on things like deep sea fish and other squid species. So of course, eating an odd land mammal like a human is very unlikely. So is it a territorial thing? Are the squids just naturally aggressive? Well, on Christmas Eve 2015, a giant squid swam into the bay around Toyama City in Japan. A nearby owner of a diver's shop, Akinobu Kimura, suited up and jumped in. The squid didn't seem aggressive. At one point it did wrap its tentacles around Mr. Kimura, but when it did, he simply guided it out of the harbor and into the open ocean, and the squid swam off. It was a juvenile giant squid, so maybe being grabbed by an adult would have ended badly. But I still don't know that they're aggressive. I mean, are giant squids really swimming thousands of feet up to the surface just to start a fight? Coming to the surface doesn't really make sense. Almost like something went wrong, and it kind of did. The squid that come to the surface are usually sick or wounded. As the invertebrate zoologist Dr. Mike Vecchione put it, if these squid are in the shallows, they're sick or dying. And it makes sense when we think about how in multiple accounts, the squids are floating on the surface. Giant squids keep ammonia in their muscular tissue to enhance buoyancy, and it is thought that they can float. So a dying one, unable to move very much, may float to the surface. And the wrapping of tentacles around the vessel? Well, it seems like the squid may just be holding on to whatever is nearby, since it's lost the energy to swim. Maybe it's just feeling and investigating this new object, like a shark's mouth with a foreign entity. I don't know that we have to brand any and every interaction as an attack. Again, we really don't know a lot about the behavior of a giant squid, so maybe it was attacking, but I don't think it was. Now, I'm not trying to be a weird squid apologist. It just doesn't make sense to me. I think it's easy for the people involved to perceive the encounter as an attack. If you saw a large mass in the water, and then it grabbed hold of your boat, you definitely might feel like you're under attack. But the squid doesn't gain anything from attacking. I guess there is some danger, as it seems they have caused smaller boats to capsize, but the danger there is more from drowning, as the squids usually leave people in the water alone. An adult specimen might be dangerous if it grabs someone, but it is extremely rare to even see a giant squid in the ocean, so the odds of a giant squid hurting a human are probably next to nothing. So please don't feel like you should be worried about squid if you go swimming. Thanks for watching this video. Please consider subscribing if you enjoyed it. And these were just some of my thoughts on giant squids. If you have any of your own thoughts or theories, please feel free to post them below. Again, thank you so much for watching, and have a great day.